So I remember what it was like to go to summer camp and ask for a vegetarian meal. Now, usually I'd get like a salad, fries, maybe a tomato sandwich, and I was very grateful for that. But there were other times where I got something a little more rustic. But what I'm really grateful for now is the incredible variety and accessibility of vegan and vegetarian foods on the market. The city of Edmonton currently boasts 26 fully vegan and vegetarian restaurants. It also hosts an annual Veg Fest, has its own vegan butcher shop, as well as its own fake meat production facility. Vegan options in the last 2 to 3 years have appeared everywhere. Companies like Danone and Maple Leaf have recently acquired other companies to diversify their dairy and meat alternative products. And companies like Beyond Meat have blossomed, with its own stock price going up by 300% in 1 month. So my question is this, is there such thing as too many vegans in Alberta? So in Canada, veganism has always been a dietary trend, and it's existed on the margins of the food market. I wanted to talk to some restaurant owners, as well as members of the beef industry, to see if they could explain the sudden boom in veganism in recent years.
There was a lot of people that were very excited about having a vegan bar or pub that they could go to. A lot of people were not as excited. There were people calling for us to be charged with false advertisement. There was people who were calling for boycotts. There were people who, I don't know what they do in their lives or how successful they are, were telling us that we were making the biggest mistake of our lives and it would surely fail. But 6 years later, here we are, happy, healthy, and doing quite well.
All right, so the next restaurant we're visiting is very near and dear to my heart and my family's heart because it was the very first restaurant I could go to and order absolutely anything I wanted on the menu. And you know, it's still doing well 17 years later because it's 2 o'clock on a Tuesday and I can't find parking.
The whole idea of eating plant-based was something that is so foreign for a lot of Edmontonians. I would say the first 4 years was really tough. We were a small restaurant in Chinatown. It was more like a hole in a wall. And we moved here to this location about 11 years ago. And as you see, the transition of this diet has definitely outgrown in the city. Currently, there's 15 plant-based restaurants. People know what plant-based are. People are more open towards it. You know, it's still hard. Any business is hard, but it's a bit easier because people know, what they're getting themselves into.
So I'm headed right now to La Poutine, one of the first places I heard of that sold vegan poutine, long before Tim Hortons, long before Cineplex Theaters started selling meat-free gravy. I'm really excited, so let's go check it out.
We have 5 or 6 different vegan options. When we started out 8 years ago, we had maybe only a few customers that were super, super like enthusiastic and grateful for the vegan options on the menu. Obviously, 8 years later, it has grown quite a bit. We have a really big following for our poutine.
Doesn't get more Canadian than this.
I think it's here to stay. I think as humans, we're here always to kind of learn and grow and become more aware of what our bodies need and that kind of thing. We're always learning to honor ourselves more as we age. So I think that that's just part of it. I think certain groups are realizing that that's what works for them. And there's other groups that don't feel that way, and that's okay.
In 2015, the City of Edmonton Youth Council passed a motion to make all catering for their events fully vegan. They also proposed this motion to the regular city council, but it wasn't met with as much positivity. I took a trip down to City Hall to talk to City Councilor Andrew Knack about this.
You know, I know when that motion first came forward, there we did have some of the industries, some folks in the meat industry, I think, reach out just to sort of say, hey, we're willing to talk, we're willing to engage. And again, I think that it was maybe viewed as a, well, this is going to change everything versus a, here's a one small piece that could change. Particularly the chair of Youth Council at that time, she heard from a lot of people. And unfortunately, a lot of the correspondence that came forward to her, and you saw it in the comments section of almost every story, how people were just being so derogatory and disrespectful. Like there wasn't any, you know, respectful dialogue about what are the merits of something like this coming forward.
While Edmonton's cruelty-free food scene seems to be growing, a few restaurants have also had to change their menus or move locations in order to sustain themselves. One of these restaurants is Veggie Garden, a Vietnamese fusion restaurant in downtown Edmonton that's actually in the same location as Edmonton's very first vegetarian restaurant. Despite Veggie Garden's great reviews and affordability, they are really struggling with rising property costs. So, are there too many vegans in Alberta? Probably not. But is there an oversaturation of the vegan market? Answers are still mixed. One thing I learned is that at the end of the day, a good restaurant has to be a good restaurant first. Now, there are other factors, as with any business, that can make or break this, such as marketing, relationship with clients, timing. So how do you feel about veganism in Alberta? Is it here to stay, or should people like me enjoy it just as long as it lasts? Comment below and stay posted by hitting that subscribe button.